Hello, in this video we will start building the hire screen. So go ahead and double click on it and assign a detail type of screen to it. Drag three separator elements to the screen and give them all a line style of no line. Drag a table element to the screen. Adjust the width of the first cell to 7% and leave the second width of 50%. Give the table a black background color. Drag a text element inside the second cell. Write personal info in the text box. Select a yellow font color. This is the structure we will use for these titles. Drag a separator element and put its line style to no line. Next, we drag a table element. This element will have three cells with the respective widths of 45, 10 and 45%. Give the table element itself a width of 80%. In the first cell, drag a text element in which we write name. In the third cell, drag another text element and write surname. Drag another table element onto the screen and define three cells inside of it of a width of 45, 10 and 45%. Give the table element itself a width of 80% and a centered alignment. In the first cell, place an input type of element and give it a reference name of name. Do the same for the third cell, but this time set a reference name of surname. Reference names must be unique within the same page or section. You cannot use spaces in these reference names or special characters. Now add a separator with no line and let's repeat exactly what we just did. The vehicle section will only have one field, with the reference of vehicle. In the cell next to it, instead of a second field, this time we'll put a text element. This text element will hold the following text: 1 to 6, 2 points, see footer. Okay, now we have our reservation form ready. All we have to do now is define a text or image element as sending button for all the created fields. To do this, let's add a separator with a style of no line and an image element. Press the select property and upload the higher button image from the higher folder. Center it on the screen and give it a width of around 45%. When you have input fields on the screen, you have the action submit available. So let's assign to our higher button the action of submit form. Now click on the properties button in order to choose a sending method of our fields or the values they are holding. You can send to a phone, a script, or an email in case you have the cloud hired. This we will do later. So next, drag a text element to create our footer, which hasn't been done yet. Inside the text element, write the following text: 1 score minivan, 2 score refrigerated minivan, 3 score van, 4 score refrigerated van, 5 score truck, 6 score refrigerated truck, and that is all. Set a white font color and a black background color. Okay, that is all for now. In our next video, we will insert our menu and header bars to the screen. Thank you for watching.